What's up, guys? I just got back from the Summer Breeze Festival in Germany, and I'm going to share my thoughts with you on a party that I think you shouldn't be missing out on. To start out, you know, having been to many European festivals in the past, I was really excited to try what many call the Mini Wacken. This one taking place in Dinkelsbühl, Germany. And as I always tell people, what really separates any festival is a great lineup, location, and vibe. And Summer Breeze Open Air Festival is definitely one that you should keep on your radar. Made up of three centralized stages, Summer Breeze is not the biggest nor the smallest fest in Europe. It's a perfect size, bringing in just over 40,000 attendees to a giant field of good times, packed to the brim with incredible talent, with organizers putting very careful attention into the booking. The lineup this year ranged from iconic mainstays like King Diamond, Queensryche, and Emperor, to amazing up-and-comers like Gall's Word, Zielenarder, and Una Misere, and even some bands I've been dying to see but never play America, like Hamford. All that said, you might find yourself with very little downtime other than running between the three stages, but they are all centrally located and really easy to get to, so it's great. Speaking of stages, let's talk about the main stage, because to put it bluntly, it's huge. The biggest I've ever seen, actually. It's also unique in the fact that there's only one. You know, where most big festivals will have two main stages that stagger performances back to back, Summer Breeze utilizes a state-of-the-art custom-built rotating platform that allows large level changeovers in record time. So you wind up with this larger-than-life stage for all the main events, capable of handling all the attendees in capacity comfortably without sacrificing really any time whatsoever. If you do need to break away, you can hit the market that sells all sorts of apparel, jewelry, music, and plenty of different cuisine stands that range from German, Asian, Indian, and much more. The festival does offer a VIP section with some really chill seating areas, bars, and mobile bathrooms. The fest is so big it even has a mini supermarket. Of course, for any campers at the festival, which this festival does offer. And speaking of campsites, these are some of the nicest that I've ever had the pleasure of walking through. If you've ever been camping at a metal festival before, you know they can get pretty dank even just after one day. So, and it does not just stop there. The festival grounds are also some of the cleanest I've ever seen in my life. And this is in part because Summer Breeze does not hand out disposable cups, but opts for a deposit system where you pay €2 for a hard plastic cup that is good to trade in with every drink at either, you know, any bar stand or cocktail stand found throughout the fest. Simple, but incredibly effective at keeping thousands of plastic cups off the floor. And I really don't know why more festivals don't adopt this system. So what are the downsides? Well, I have to say, you know, being situated right outside the city of Dinkelsbühl, if I'm even pronouncing that correctly, it's not exactly the easiest place to get to, being either an hour or 2 hours away from the closest airports by car. So it could be a bit of a trek that requires some planning for travelers to pan out. And it's not as simple as some of the events that might occur within major cities, for instance, Montreal. However, I am a firm believer that traveling for music festivals is a great way to see the world and, you know, experience new things. And that Dinkelsbühl is 1,000% worth your time alone. It's even known to the German residents as the prettiest city that they have in the country, and I certainly do not disagree. This city is definitely quaint and can be found inside fortified walls, and it's just as picturesque as you can possibly get, with all the amenities you could ever want if camping is not your style. Summer Breeze does set up a free shuttle to and from the city center to the festival grounds every day to make it easy for anyone who wants to experience the event but stay in this romantic town, fit for a king. With all that said, the biggest takeaway that I even realized within the first hour of being at this festival is the amazing vibe that happens at Summer Breeze Open Air. To be honest, I've had some awful experiences at European festivals before, simply because the residents' attitude towards outside travelers. But I've always considered Germany to be one of the nicest European countries, and happy to report that this is definitely true of everyone I met at Summer Breeze. Germany has a ton of English speakers who are just happy and even eager to help and speak with you with zero attitude about it. And that alone is just such a comforting, inviting atmosphere for any newcomer. At the end of the day, everyone was at this festival for a good time, not just for themselves, but together, and it felt like family. And many times I even forget that I was in a foreign country because it was so inviting. So if you're looking for your next or even your first European festival experience with zero attitude, all the gratitude, a massive stage, a killer lineup, and all the best people and vibes, check out Summer Breeze Open Air. I really think it's gonna be for you.